Hello everyone, it's me, Professor Theory. As always, my purpose for today is to give an explanation and to make you understand more regarding the topic partial fraction repeated linear factor. Let's get started. And I have prepared two examples on partial fraction with repeated linear factors. The easy one first. On the screen right now is a partial fraction. Look at the denominator. It has a square of a linear function, and this is what we meant by repeated linear factor. We cannot use the same method as the one that we use for non-repeated linear factor because we wouldn't be able to converge to a solution. So we need to decompose it into this. It is still a two-term function, but note that the second term has a repeated factor. The only way to do this is to decompose it into this. It is still a two-term partial fraction, but look at the denominators of the second term. It is a repeated factor. This is a good solution providing that A and B are numerical constant. We begin by multiplying both sides by x minus 2. This will eliminate all the denominators. And this is the format that we want. It looks simple. We can choose any value of x that will eliminate either A or B. So I have chosen to assign 2 to x. This will force the coefficient of A to become 0, leaving only B behind. And thus, we can find the value of B, and that is equal to minus 2. So what's next? We can substitute any value for x now. It doesn't really matter any value. We will still be able to find the value of A. So, I choose 4, and then proceed. And by simplifying it, then we get the value of A, which is equal to 1. But now, by putting 1 to A, then we get to the solution of example 1. Now, that was a simple example. Let's take a look at the second example, which is slightly more complicated. In this example, I have borrowed the one that Ida has presented just now. And we are going to split this into three partial fractions, like that. Now, take a look at the denominators. We have x plus 2, and then x plus 2 squared, and lastly, x minus 3. And we need to find the value of A, B, and C. The next thing to do is to eliminate the denominators by multiplying it by x plus 2 squared, x minus 3. And we get the format that we want. So now let's choose a value for x that will eliminate any two of A, B, and C. So if we substitute minus 2 for B, then we can eliminate A and C because we have forced the coefficient to become 0, leaving only B behind. And simplifying it, we get the value of B. And B is equal to minus 1. So 1 down, 2 to go. So what is the next value that we can choose to eliminate either A or C? Well, let x is equal to 3. By doing this, we can eliminate A and only leave C behind. And by simplifying it, we get the value C. So it's easy to find the value of C now. So C is equal to 2. So that's great. So the last one standing is A. We can substitute any value for x now. Any value will be good. We'll find the value of A. So I've chosen to choose x equal to 0. Well, why make our life complicated, right? And we can simplify the equation. And it's very obvious that now A is equal to 1. So let's update the value for A, B, and C into our final solution. And that's it. We have already completed our partial fraction decomposition with repeated linear factors. I hope you can do partial fraction decomposition independently now. If not, then with enough practice, you will. Thank you for your time and interest. Make sure you watch another video so that you can learn more about maths. See you again. Bye-bye.